And greetings to everybody here. It's always great coming back to Cape Town, even without the water here. And if you have had a bit of rain now. Because you know, I left you and I went back to Joburg where I come from. But it's great to be in ARDC, such a fantastic centre. So greetings to all the comrades. I suppose when we talk about getting out of the mess, and you know that translation is like getting out of the KAK, isn't it? here we are today, and the dear old military boys up north seem to have moved against Uncle Bob, and everybody's wondering what's going on. And will they get the people of Zimbabwe out of the mess? And can one ever rely on the military? And in terms of our country, could the military ever get us out of the mess? That's not obviously the focus of discussion, although surely is always a part. And as we celebrate the centenary of the Russian Revolution, and we've been analysing it down here with great internationalist John Molyneux, who was up with Mercier in Joburg last weekend, where we had really fine 3 days celebration, analysis, way ahead and so on. One is reminded of revolutions, Paris Commune, the 1917 revolution, and the military are a factor in these things and sometimes key. But the difference in looking at the Russian Revolution or the Paris Commune, where the workers were armed to defend Paris against the assault, the invasion from Bismarck's Germany, it was to defend the capital. Because the bourgeois army and the capitalist class there were not defending French sovereignty. That's an example of when workers or people raise arms to defend homeland, sovereignty, trade union rights or whatever. In relation to the Russian Revolution, it was the mutiny of the conscript, this vast Russian military, together with the working class rising, that spelt the doom of feudalism and the emperor, and then of the bourgeois class that were trying to maintain power. So I'm just saying that, given that clearly on everyone's minds today has been news out of Zimbabwe. And I'm certainly not looking, and my book doesn't project this in any way, looking to the boys in brown and women now in the military to pull us out of the mess. They might become a factor in certain circumstances, and given the contradictions of our society, as in 1917 Russia, in so many other situations, Zimbabwe now, who can say? And in the end, in terms of the way ahead and what I'm sure the three of us will be proposing and looking forward to an interaction with comrades here about the way ahead, let me say that never ignore, and I'm not suggesting anyone here would, but the whole question of ignoring the military or any state institution bearing arms is a major error. And a key aspect of that Russian Revolution is to attempt to win over the soldiers and turn the guns against the ruling class. So, who knows how we might see that unfolding, possibly a long way ahead here. But the other point, and I think it was John Molyneux and others who made the point, I'm sure here, Brian, in your discussions, and certainly up in Johannesburg, whether you want to ascribe the statement to Lenin or Trotsky or many different revolutionaries, in fact, and that is that given the contradictions within class society, the events can speed up in a most extraordinary way, and history can go slowly for decades, and then given contradictions which burst forth, events can speed up like a locomotive. And we always felt that in relation to coming to deal with the apartheid regime, and post in this democracy we now have, the contradictions are so many, and they exhibit themselves sometimes in surprising ways, in alarming ways, in horrendous ways, such as Marikana, that the society is one in which we should always expect the speeding up of those contradictions, that inevitably, and especially if the people's revolutionary organizations have done their work, mobilization, education, building the agency of change, that you then have remarkable potential to make the breakthrough. Because in terms of such turmoil, unless there is a revolutionary organization, a movement to lead the people, then the situation can be missed. And the Russian Revolution come October saw this very much in terms of how Lenin kept saying to the Bolshevik leadership that the time to act in terms of the insurrection was on hand, and if it wasn't taken, and it wasn't a question of putting it off for days, but hours, then the situation would be lost. In relation to the book isn't really about that. I'm just moved by events on our doorstep and what's pregnant within our society. The book is called A Simple Man. And just a bit of background before we can come to how to get out of or extricate and get out of the mess, the crisis that's growing all the time, I just want to spend a little bit of my time going into how we got into the mess. So, A Simple Man is looking at Jacob Zuma, not because it's Jacob Zuma who's brought us into this mess alone, and no one individual can, but he's very much to the fore and on people's minds, whether you support him or you absolutely loathe him. And I called the book A Simple Man because so many people had fallen for this profile of Jacob Zuma as a simple man of the people. Yet another in that constellation of leaders in history who come to the fore in many different countries of the world in terms of the Trumps and Mussolinis and so on. I'm a simple man of the people. I come from a poverty-stricken rural background. I've struggled. I know your problems. I'm one of you. I'm not one of the clever clevers, and especially I'm not a clever black. And I am at one with the people, a man of the people.